Okay, guys, do you want to know about a great book about autism that you can read? Well, here it is. There it is right there. This is a fabulous book. It's written by two siblings. It's a memoir, and the two siblings write in different styles. The brother writes in like a comic form. It's really creative and witty, very witty. In fact, it's hilarious. I love these siblings. They are so adorable. They really are so adorable. They write from a perspective from like the 1950s when their brother, I believe, was born in the 50s. So it's through like the 60s and 70s and 80s and 90s and all the way up till like 2001, I think it ends. But it's really a great book. And I would encourage you to go out and read this. It's a book about autism in a simpler time, although their life was not simple at all. And it extrapolates things like, talks about just kind of the hard issues that they had to deal with, but it doesn't go into so much detail that it overwhelms you. It's very minimalistic in its expression about life with autism, but at the same time gives you enough insight where you get the feeling of how hard it was for them and how hard it was for their parents. So it's just a great book. It is unique. It's a different style, and I like different styles of writing, and I like the creativity behind it, and I like the empathy from the sister, and I love the really funny, witty comic style of communication in the book about the memoir part of it from the brother, Paul. So it's just a really great book. And I think that we need more books like this, especially from the past. I'm definitely gonna finish the memoir that I'm working on, that I've worked on for many years, and I just could never complete it because it just was never the right time to complete it. But we're getting close to that time, and it's important to show people what it was. I mean, I had my son in 1989, so I raised him through the early 90s, so that was a very different time than this book is talking about raising, someone in the 50s and 60s and 70s. So there's, every single decade should have somebody writing a memoir about what it was like and, how the struggles were and how it evolved and how we may have devolved and how we need to keep fighting and we need to keep, ensuring that justice is done for people who have special needs, especially people with autism, and how we need to keep, putting their stories out there so that we can hear their voices, especially when they can't tell us, or, even if they are verbal, they have a hard time communicating what they've been through. So it's important that siblings and parents and anybody else who knows these people, to the extent that is worthy of being able to write a memoir, it's important. Because a memoir from someone who grew up with autism is vastly different than an academic writing about autism. To me, I can't stand books from academics. I don't care if you have a PhD 9 times over, okay? I'm not impressed. If you have not lived with autism, I don't want to hear it. I don't want to hear it because it's all some vague, ambiguous view that you have. I mean, I'm sure your book is helpful, but you could never write a memoir because you didn't live it. It's impossible. No amount of education will ever teach you what it's like to live with people with autism and the ebb and flow of what that's like, and all the idiosyncrasies and the battles and the inspirational times and the great and joyful times and the miraculous times. You won't know that. But you can't write like that when you haven't lived with it. So I encourage people to buy memoirs of people who have actually lived with autism. And for a reasonable amount of time, by the way, not someone who, like, your kid was 3 years old and you wrote a book about autism. Hello? What? That'd be like, a soldier writing a book about Vietnam and he, flew over to Vietnam and flew back. No. You need to have a little more experience, okay? All right, so anyway, you know what I mean? So Can we just keep it real? Let's find books about people who either have autism. I love reading books about people who actually have autism too, the higher functioning ones. Those are amazing. And then of course there's, you know, people like my son who can't write his own book and somebody has to speak for him. And that's completely reasonable and we need to do it because they have a voice and it needs to be heard and it's important. But anyway, get this book. Again, these two siblings are so cute and so funny. So funny. I read the book in 3 days. It was so good. And I just love the how unique it is. So give it a shot. It really is a cute book and funny and heartwarming. And there are some sad, kind of sad things at the end, but not so sad that you can't continue reading and can't feel so good. But it's actually the end part is something that we've experienced too. So when I saw that, I was like, oh gosh, this stuff's been going on for years. So just try it. It is a very good book. And again, I love these siblings. They are so adorable. And I just, you can just feel the love in their heart that they have for their brother and that they had all those years. And their family is so amazing and remarkable. I love the parents. They're obviously not, you know, here anymore, but just their whole family is really cool. Really cool family. You got to read the book.